His voice embodied the hopes and dreams of young Iranians, and his commitment to freedom of speech made him a thorn in the side of the regime. Iranian rapper Toomaj Salehi was sentenced to death on Wednesday by a revolutionary court on charges of corrupting the moral order. The 33-year-old artist was arrested in October 2022 after publicly backing a wave of protests sparked by the death of Mahsa Amini. His arrest triggered a wave of support from artists around the world, including Iranian writer and director Marjan Satrapi.
He's the only Iranian rapper who speaks about the working class and the underprivileged. His lyrics are political and he wields the Persian language like no one else. He's a poet. He's extremely popular in Iran. He's become a symbol for his generation and for the country.
A symbol which the Iranian regime could no longer tolerate. In this clip, Toomaj sits across a man dressed in black, supposed to represent the mullahs and the Revolutionary Guard. His sentencing comes amid a renewed crackdown on civil liberties in Iran, especially against women refusing to wear the hijab. Toomaj Salehi's lawyer said he would appeal the decision, which contradicts a previous Supreme Court ruling that spared him the death penalty. شما نورتون زیاد شهر تاریکو دیدید اینجا که باری که کمر چون خونه رو مکیدید اینجا که کسافتتون رو از بالا میریزید نفت میبرن میخرن گله سگ هارن قلاده دارن پنجه به مردم و سر تو توبره خبرنگار و مجری کورن یکی از قدرت یکی از رو میریختن گرفتار کسبتی وقتی جون جوونا رو میگیرن اگه وسط بازی وسط بودی و گفتی سیاست چی هست بدون رأی سفید نداریم بی طرف نداره این جنگ بدون مال کشیدن تو این سیستم کامل نیست ایران اینقدر زندان داره که همتون جا بشین تنها بدار میگیرم تو آغوشم من با افتخار گول نمیشه صدامون تو قلب این حصار میبینیم هم دیگر رو باز اونور دیوار رفیق کلید خون تو قفل آزادی بذار میگیرم تو آغوشم من با افتخار دارا و ندار اثر قوم و تبار مثل فشنگ قطار میدون جنگ تیغه شمشیر عشق شهامت و زین کن و جنس سپر وفا
Welcome everyone to Revolution Books. My name is Miles Soleil. I'm a musician and I am a longtime part of the family here at Revolution Books. Revolution Books, for those who've never been before, this is the intellectual and political center of a movement for an actual revolution to overthrow the system of capitalism, imperialism. The foundation of this store and everything that we're doing is embodied best in the Constitution for the New Socialist Republic in North America, written by Bob Avakian, revolutionary communist leader whose works you can find right over here and on the website Revolution Books and at revcom.us. We're doing this program today, as you have just seen, as a contribution and as a unique perspective and stand, but as a contribution to a movement that is urgently needed yesterday. And that is to stop the execution and free Toomaj Salehi. Toomaj, who is one of thousands of political prisoners in Iran, is an artist. He's a musician. He's 33, maybe 34 years old at this point. He's basically been in and out of prison for the last 2 or 3 years. He's, for those, which I'm gathering is most of us, certainly myself, who don't speak Farsi, Persian, which itself is a beautiful language, he's a brilliant poet, a brilliant writer, and he's someone, as you're beginning to get a taste of, whose heart and soul and statement and stand and numerous songs and music videos have been given to the people, the oppressed and downtrodden of Iran, a country that for 40 years, over 40 years, has been ruled by not an anti-imperialist regime, but a fascist, theocratic, capitalist, and aspiring imperialist regime that is run, and when we say theocratic, meaning the society, the governing laws of society are straight out of the Dark Ages. I want to interrupt myself, even though we've got a multimedia program for you guys today, for everyone who's watching or here in the room, I really just want to encourage everyone to watch Toomaj's music videos. There's only about 7, 8, maybe 10 of them that have the English subtitles on YouTube. But you can not only learn more about him, but you can learn a fair amount around, as I have in the last few months, over the sacrifice and the struggle and the hypocrisy and brutality of the Iranian regime. Before we move forward, and I do want to just tell everyone that this is going to be a really powerful and deep program that we're doing, I just want to tell you guys that we've got this image here of a young woman, a young Kurdish woman, Mahsa Amini, who a few years ago in Iran, now Iran, like many countries, Iran is a... It's a country where half the population are women. And in Iran, there is the mandatory wearing of the hijab, meaning women are forced, you have to, that's what mandatory is, wear the hijab, the covering. And while it's by no means the only, in many ways, it has concentrated the brutality, Dark Ages mentality of the theocratic regime, in particular, how it has oppressed women every single day for 40 years. This young woman was one of probably millions over the last few decades who either chose to not abide by the mandatory hijab law and just let her beautiful hair flow like a human being, or maybe she was doing it in a way that wasn't acceptable to the regime, and she was seized by the morality police and brutalized and beaten up and murdered. And that inspired tremendous uprising all throughout Iran a few years ago, to the extent which there were millions of people, young women, but also many men and people from many different parts of the society, not only calling out this outrage, but saying, what do they call him, the Ayatollah? What is the Supreme Leader, that Khomeini got to go, and his predecessor Khomeini got to go. And it was, for those who were paying attention or saw what was going on, it was so fucking inspiring to... A again, not only to see people rising up against this oppression, but it was actually very refreshing to see people saying this whole regime has got to go. And in the context of that really heroic uprising, and it's really important because the war on women exists in Iran, it exists in the United States, it exists throughout Latin America, it exists in India, it exists all over this planet. And any revolution or any struggle to change the world that doesn't include that or have that as its center is not a movement that's actually about changing the world in any kind of good direction. And in the context of that, Toomaj, who had been making music against this regime and trying to inspire the youth, and also very vociferously going at a lot of the other rappers and other people who had made their peace with this system there. Toomaj, as you saw in one of those videos right there, there was a little clip of him in the streets, not only released songs, this is The Battlefield, which we're going to watch later, the No Hijab song that he did with Justina, but he also actually joined the protest and posted social media videos of himself in the streets. And this was tremendously inspiring. And he was imprisoned and threatened with execution. And last, he was sentenced to death, and he was in prison for almost a year where he was tortured. They broke his arms, they broke his fingers. And they tried to get him, like they do with all political prisoners, they tried to get him to concede and go along with the system. And he was let out, and he didn't apologize for his words, and they put him back in prison. And just 2 months ago, he was sentenced to execution. And we don't know when that execution date is going to be. They execute, if you average it out, the Islamic Republic of Iran executes a few people every day. So later in the program, we're going to hear from Raymond Lada, is going to be talking more about the movement that exists, but most importantly, the movement that all of us need to be part of instigating to stop this execution and free Toomaj. We also have the main part of this program is a tremendous talk from a revolutionary from Iran, Mona, who's a former political prisoner. And so the last thing I just want, you guys with me? Yeah, we're good? Says here, Miles, that's me, speaks 3 to 5 minutes. I'm starting that 3 to 5 minutes right now. The last thing I want to say before we move on in the program, move forward in the program, is that, you know, we're obviously here in the United States. This is the country that is right now funding a genocide in Palestine. This is a country, the only country in human history that has ever dropped nuclear weapons on human beings in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And there is no other country in the history of civilization, of which there are quite a few bad ones, that has caused so much untold suffering through invasions, occupations, and the watchword that they like to use or phrase, regime change. And so I just want to make very clear that those of us at this bookstore and part of this program and the RevCom movement, everything we stand for is against the theocracy of the Islamic Republic of Iran, and we support revolutionaries and all people of conscience. They're rising up against that regime. But make no mistake, we are not here registering our statement with the hypocrite with blood on his hands, Anthony Blinken from the Secretary, the Department of State of this country, or any of the rulers of the United States who so disgustingly and hypocritically try to condemn the rulers of Iran while they commit war crimes on a far grander scale that the mullahs in Iran could only ever dream of. So I just want to make that very clear, that we hear, and this is what you're going to hear more of, so please, everyone on the live stream and here, stick with this. This is what you're going to hear more of, but I want to make it very clear from the beginning. We are not choosing one because we don't like the other. They both got to go. Yeah, right. So I want to watch another music video. You guys want to watch another music video? Okay, so we're going to turn the lights off. Those on the live stream, you might actually have a better chance of this. This has subtitles in English. So try to focus. This is a rat hole is the name of this song. You know, I have to say it was so hard to pick videos to share with this because they're all so good and so deep. And I am a songwriter, and I do believe I've written some good songs, but I've been blown away by how great this writer, Toomaj Salehi, is on a whole other level. This song is called Rat Hole. I'll let the song speak for itself, but let's just say that he's got words for those who conciliate themselves or find their own niche and go along with horrors. So I'm going to turn these lights off and we're going to watch Rat Hole, Mouse Hole.
اگه دیدی درد مردمو ولی چشا تو بستی، ظلم به مظلوم رو دیدی و از کنارش رفتی، اگه از ترس یا واسه منفعتت خودی کردی، تو هم دست ظالم هستی، تو هم مجرم هستی. اگه خودتو به خواب زدی وقتی که خونه ها رو میریختن، گرفتار کسبتی وقتی جون جوون ها رو میگیرن، اگه وسط بازی وسط بودی و گفتی سیاست چی هست، بدون رأی سفید نداریم، بی طرف نداره این جنگ. اگه دست رو چشمات گذاشتی دستات خونین، خائنی اگه تریبون داری و حرفات بومیدن، دوری از وطن و دوربینای ما سو نیستن، یادت باشه کسافتای پشت ابر ها میرن. اگه سرپوش گذاشتی رو قتل، تو هم قاتلی، واسه پوشوندن جنایت باید رو خون راه بری، بدون مال کشیدن تو این سیستم کامل نیست، ایران اینقدر زندان داره که همتون جا بشین. ژورنالیست بازداری، مخبر دوزداری، هنرمند درباری، سوراخ موش بخر، مامور منظور، از بالا دستور، جلاد مجبور، سوراخ موش بخر، سوپا پت مینان، منصوب بی اختیار، اصلاح طلب حزب، با سوراخ موش بخر، صادراتی نایی یا کیسی رو رو کشار، جایی بده هرچی دلار داری، سوراخ موش بخر. چه هنرمندی که خبر از نونخوری نداری، شاشیدن به اسکار تگ مردمی نباشی، پاره میکنم کلافه تو که دیگه چرن نبافی، چه شهاب دولتی باشی چه اصغر فرهادی، چه بازیکن حکومتی و چفی الیسی، چه بازیگر صادراتی و اله ایکسی، شما خود فروش پولی نرزه مقام فیکسین، حیف سالو جیر خورا شما از خلایق نیستین، لاشی کارون باب مدنی که پر نمیشه، خوزستان شتون نمیخواد صاحب کل نمیزه، آزادی گرونه باشه آزاده کشته میده، یادتون باشه خون فقط با خون شست نمیشه. تیر بزن از پشت سر بکشتش نهارو، به قتل حق خواه نامسلح افتخار کن، بیرون مرز به جنایت بزن رنگ و لعاب رو، بگیر از من مژده فردا و تقاس رو. ژورنالیست بازداری، مخبر دوزداری، هنرمند درباری، سوراخ موش بخر، مامور منظور، از بالا دستور، جلاد مجبور، سوراخ موش بخر، سوپا پت مینان، منصوب بی اختیار، اصلاح طلب حزب، با سوراخ موش بخر، صادراتی نایی یا کیسی رو رو کشار، جایی بده هرچی دلار داری، سوراخ موش بخر. منتظر ناجی نباش، خبری تو راه نیست، نجات دهنده خودتی، خودت قهرمانی، من و تو اگه ما بشیم کرانیم، ما منجی زمانیم، امام زمانیم.
شما قاضی وطن، عدل انتهام، برزخ خودم، وحشت شما سرباز حقم، مرگ افتخار من خروشه ی خشمم غیزم ریزشه ی صدم سیلم از درون یه رنگم طفلم لطیف مثل مرگم شعرم ای بل بشکن قانون نداریم قول میدم خوابی رو آروم نذاریم قول میدم کمتر تا اون نباشیم متحد میشیم و با اتون فراریم بده به من بده ایران مال منه بده به من بده این خاک مال منه بده به من بده ایران شده همش بده که من خودم میسازمش بده به من بده ایران مال منه بده به من بده این خاک مال منه بده به من بده ایران شده همش بده که من خودم میسازمش
میسازمش توی خاک ریشم بمیرم هم رو ورق زاده میشم منم تعبیر کابوس خواب این شهر زنجیر ظلم میشه پاره بیشم قطره سرخ تو چشماتم اشک مادرای داغ دارم خونابه خوزستانم بنزینم شعله آبانم اختار کشتار بعد وضعیت گلوله شلیک تو سر جمعیت من خونه زیر پوتینم خورش دبینم با تعم کریزک کلی خط رو بدن همه قربانی با سر تو لجن زخ تو کمر وقت تو سرم همونی هم کر وقت پر زد هر وقت حرف زد سیستمت مورفین زد تو رگم دوختن هی نخ رو لبم دود کرد سوختم مثل جنگل آزاد راست قانونت فوت کرد از تک تک خونا که ریختی خوردی گذشته یه دریا آب از سرم میسوزم توی جهنم ولی میزنم بیرون خاکستر من جاودانم توی چرخ تکرار زاده جنگم به دست اجبار پشت اتحاد تو صورت ظلمم از شمال و جنوب تا قلب تهران پایبند به خاک و عهد و پیمان امید به یأسم تو بطن زندان سرود دردم غروب تلخم روشنگرم روی سطح کیهان غیظم بمبم مینه زیر پا تلخی و خشمم با رخ بینقاب فریاد یه نسل غرق زیر آب کینه کهنم از عمق سینه ها ایول بشکن قانون نداریم قول میدم خوابی آروم نذاریم قول میدم کمتر تا اون نباشیم متحد میشیم و باهاتون فراری بده به من بده ایران مال منه بده به من بده این خاک مال منه بده به من بده ایران شده همش بده که من خودم میسازمش بده به من بده ایران مال منه بده به من بده این خاک مال منه بده به من بده ایران شده همش بده که من خودم میسازمش
شعلم زاده ی شلیک خودته ما شهرم نیزارم
من راویم و تاریخ خود شعر یادار که مرگ نسیانم
یادار که مرگ نسیانم
I chose that, like, I mean, I wasn't lying. You really, all of the songs are so powerful. This last one, the second rapper is Toomaj's best friend, Afrasiab, who is still alive and still in Iran and actually released a song a month ago on his Instagram page. And I don't know if you guys missed the subtitles or the little statement at the beginning of this, but a previous time that Toomaj was arrested and was tortured and was a political prisoner, when he was released, he made that music video. And I don't know if you noticed, but that music video was filmed in front of the prison that he was in. Which to me, I just have to say, you know, stands in stark contrast to the complicity, and you contrast that with the complicity and silence of just hundreds of thousands of artists, you know, who refuse to speak out against the genocide in Gaza because they know they'll lose career opportunities, they'll lose it's just, I'm just telling you my mindset over the last few months, and you just see somebody who is not just views themselves as a martyr, but actually has tremendous courage and conviction that what they're saying is right and is fearless in the face of the enemy. And that is just, we're not here to breed pessimism. We're here to actually try to organize a movement to stop his execution and free him. But I just think that that type of courage and sacrifice is something we could all learn from. I want to just read two statements that we receive, and then I'm going to introduce the main part of our program, the main speech. Geraldine Brooks, a Pulitzer Prize-winning novelist who reported from Iran frequently from the late 1980s through the 1990s, sent this message. Toomaj is an example of the greatness of Iranian artists who, at immense sacrifice to themselves, have stayed in their homeland to fight for the heart and soul of their culture. Dr. Cornel West wrote in and said, I salute Revolution Books. I am in deep solidarity with Brother Toomaj. I have strongly condemned the death sentence for a hip-hop artist telling the truth about repression in Iran. I'm very excited to introduce and to present to you guys a revolutionary communist leader and former political prisoner, someone who was in these dungeons and hellholes in Iran, who has come here to speak with us today. Mona Roshana. This presentation here. You ready?
Thank you so much. Hi everybody, and thank you so much to invite me here. I'm so glad to be here. And I start my presentation, statement by Farsi, and some my friend gonna translate it by English.
One second, I'm sorry. Yeah. We're having a technical difficulty with the live stream.
Oh.
We're just gonna wait 1 second.
I think it's okay.
Can you ask them if it's okay?
Somebody should
do it. Sorry.
You get a little audio.
Is the live stream working?
It's okay.
Are you sure, Janet?
Yeah, I see the.
Great. Okay. So sorry about that.
No, that's okay. Thank you so much. Yeah, I started again. Hi, everybody. I'm so glad to be here, and thank you so much to invite me here. And I start my statement by Farsi, and some of my friend gonna translate it English. من مونا روشن هستم. در دهه 60 هنگامی که 20 ساله بودم با عنوان یک زن کمونیست انقلابی توسط جمهوری اسلامی دستگیر شدم و 3 سال در زندان بودم و فرزند اولم را زمانی که تحت شکنجه های جمهوری اسلامی بودم به دنیا آوردم. 45 سال از شروع شلی فرمان حجاب اجباری خمینی میگذره و جنگ این رژیم دینمدار فاشیست علیه زنان هنوز ادامه داره. مقاومت 45 ساله زنان به اوجهایی رسیده است، مانند خیزش زن زندگی آزادی، اما هنوز نتوانسته به ورای مقاومت بره و تبدیل به انقلاب برای سرنگونی جمهوری اسلامی بشه. بر بستر افت خیزش ژینا و همچنین بعد از شروع نسل کشی نئونازی در غزه، خامنه ای فاشیست احساس کرد آزادانه تر از گذشته میتواند سرکوب زنان و کشتار زندانیان را به پیش ببره. در 7 ماه گذشته سرکوب زنان شدیدتر شده و اعدام ها سرعت گرفتند. هر 5 ساعت یک زندانی غیر سیاسی اعدام می شود. زندانیان سیاسی در اعتراض به اعدام زندانیان غیر سیاسی هر 3 شنبه اعتصاب غذا می کنند. برخی زندانیان سیاسی کرد که بیش از 10 سال در زندان بودند اعدام شدند.
My name is Mona Roshan. When I was 20 years old, I was arrested by the Islamic Republic of Iran because of my activities as a revolutionary communist woman. I was in prison for 3 years, giving birth to my first child when I was under torture by the Islamic Republic. 45 years have passed since the rebellion against Khomeini's compulsory hijab decree. The war on women by the theocratic fascist regime of Iran is still going full force. The 45 years of a resistance by women reached its height in the Women Life Freedom Uprising of 2022-23, but as yet has not been able to go beyond protest and become a revolution to overthrow the Islamic regime of Iran. After the repression of the Mahsa Jinnah uprising, coinciding with the Neton Nazi genocide in Gaza, the fascist supreme leader Khamenei felt that he could proceed freely more than ever before to carry out even more repression against women and murder more prisoners. In the past 7 months, the repression against women has intensified and executions have accelerated. Every 5 hours, a prisoner is executed in Iran. As we speak, political prisoners go on a hunger strike every Tuesday to protest against the executions. Some Kurdish political prisoners who have been imprisoned for more than 10 years have been among those executed.
حملات پلیس در شهر به زنان بی‌حجاب به عملیات مخصوص در دانشگاه‌ها علیه دختران دانشجو گسترش پیدا کرده به طوری که اداره حراست دختران دانشجو را گروهی تحویل نیروهای پلیس می‌دهد. پلیس آزادی آنها را مشروط به تست بکارت و اعتیاد کرده است. این نقل قول میشه از برنامه بی بی سی در جوان 2024. تجاوز به زنان زندانی و بازداشتی توسط عفو بین‌الملل مستند شده است. نرگس محمدی درخواست کرده است که دادگاهش علنی برگزار شود تا شرح تجاوز مردان حکومت به زنان بازداشتی و زندانی را به مردم بدهد. اکنون عده‌ای از زنان در حال مستند کردن تجاوز و تعرض جنسی به زنان زندانی سیاسی و غیر سیاسی هستند. من نیز تجربه آزار جنسی توسط شکنجه‌گران اسلامگرا را داشتم. همه کسانی که علیه جمهوری اسلامی مبارزه می کنند در جنگ با خدا محسوب می شوند و در این جنگ هر زنی که اسیر شود مانند برده ایست که طبق شرع اسلام می توانند به او تعرض جنسی کنند. تعرض جنسی به زنان قانون همیشگی جنگ های ارتجاعی است، اما در جمهوری اسلامی فتوای قانونی برای آن صادر شده و با شرع توجیه می شود.
Police attacks on women not wearing hijab in the cities have expanded, along with special operations against female students, with the Department of Security handing over arrested female students in groups to police forces. The police have made the release of those arrested conditional on virginity and addiction tests. This is according to the statement released by the sociology students of the University of Tehran, broadcast on BBC on June 6th, just as a few days ago. The rape of women in prison and detention centers have been documented by Amnesty International. Nargis Mohammadi, the imprisoned Iranian human rights advocate who won the 2023 Nobel Peace Prize, has requested that her upcoming trial be held in public so she can expose the rape of detained and imprisoned women by the regime's male authorities. Iranian women activists are documenting the rape and sexual assault of women prisoners by the authorities. I was one of the victims of her sexual harassment by Islamist torturers many years ago. All those who fight against the Islamic Republic are considered, quote, at war with God. And in this war, any woman who is captured is treated as a slave who can be sexually assaulted according to Islamic laws. Sexual assaults against women have always been a component part of reactionary wars. But in the Islamic Republic, a legal fatwa decree is issued to, quote, legalize this rape.
با به قدرت رسیدن جمهوری اسلامی در سال 1979 خمینی با یک فرمان حجاب اسلامی را اجباری کرد. همونطور که گفتم آن شورش توده‌ای بزرگ که 5-6 روز طول کشید در این شورش جمعیت زنان مبارز که توسط کادرهای اتحادیه کمونیستای ایران که امروز حزب کمونیست ایران مارکسیست لنینیست است تشکیل شده بود نقش مهمی در این شورش داشت. زنان اولین نیرویی بودند که جمهوری اسلامی را به چالش کشیدند. بسیاری از جریان‌های چپ در آن زمان به خاطر کارگری نبودن این شورش آن را بی اهمیت تلقی کردند، اما در واقع نشانه آن بود که گسل ستم بر زن در این جامعه بسیار انفجاری است.
When the Islamic Republic came to power in 1979, Khomeini, then the supreme leader, issued a decree making the Islamic hijab mandatory. As I mentioned earlier, there was a great mass revolt against this, which lasted 5 to 6 days. In that revolt, the Association of Fighting Women, which was formed by the cadres of the Union of Communists of Iran, now the Communist Party of Iran, MLM, played an important role. Women were the first forces to challenge the Islamic Republic. Many leftists at that time considered the revolt to be insignificant and unnecessary because it was not about the, quote, rights of workers. Despite the fact that reality shows the oppression of women is indeed a sharp fault line and a very explosive contradiction in Iranian society.
با جمهوری اسلامی شکل‌های سنتی ستم بر زن در شکل‌های مدرن‌تر اضافه شد و این تضاد اجتماعی انفجاری‌تر شد. جمهوری اسلامی ترکیب غریبی از روابط اجتماعی اسلامی، بردهداری و روابط سرمایه‌داری امپریالیسم به وجود آورد و زنجیرهای بردگی زنان را تقویت کرد. کیس ایران حرف باباوکیان را ثابت کرد که میگوید هر جا بنیادگرایی دینی حاکم است، حاکم باشد، پدر مرد سالاری شدید و زن ستیزی تهاجمی حاکم خواهد بود.
With the Islamic Republic in power, traditional forms of the oppression of women were added to more modern forms of oppression, and this social contradiction became even more explosive. The Islamic Republic brought forth a strange combination of Islamic slavery and capitalist imperialist social relations and tightened the chains on women. The case of Iran illustrates the point made by Babavakian that wherever religious fundamentalism prevails, extreme patriarchy and aggressive misogyny will prevail.
اجازه بدید در مورد امپریالیسم نکاتی اینجا اشاره بکنم به نکاتی. جمهوری اسلامی و بنیادگرایان اسلامی درکی از امپریالیسم رو تبلیغ و ترویج کردند که نه تنها منطبق بر واقعیت نیست بلکه به شدت ارتجاعی است و به طور خلاصه ضدیت با هر تفکر، فرهنگ و روابطی است که در دوران عروج سرمایه‌داری و انقلاب‌های ضد فئودالی در قرن 18 به وجود آمد و جنبه‌های مترقی آن در جنبش روشنگری فشرده می‌شد که از دستاوردهای مهم آن تفکر انتقادی، تفکر علمی عقلانی به جای تفکر ایدئالیستی و خرافی دینی سرنگون کردن چارچوبه های سیستم سرواش و بندگی فردی بود. امروز همه آنها در روابط پدر مرد سالاری سنتی علیه زنان احیا شده است. بنیادگرایان اسلامی نسخه اجتماعی ارتجاعی خود را مبارزه علیه امپریالیسم و رهایی از امپریالیسم توصیف می کنند. آنها برای جا انداختن این تفکر و روابط اجتماعی سنتی ارتجاعی به عنوان راه رهایی بخش از این واقعیت استفاده کردند که غرب که مهد تحولات ضد فئودالی بود خودش تبدیل به غرب امپریالیست خوناشام، ویرانگر و غارتگر و استعمارگر شد. آنها از این واقعیت برای رهایی بخش جلوه دادن بازگشت به تفکرات دینی و روابط اجتماعی ستمگرانه گذشته استفاده می کنند.
Let me say some things about imperialism. The Islamic Republic and the Islamic fundamentalists have propagated and promoted a twisted concept of imperialism that not only does not correspond to reality, but is also highly reactionary. In short, it stands against any rational thought, culture, and relations that arose after the rise of capitalism and the anti-feudal revolutions in the 18th century, whose progressive aspects were compressed into the Enlightenment movement. One of the Enlightenment's important achievements was critical thinking, scientific and rational thought, in opposition to idealistic and superstitious religious views that reinforced the system of serfdom and servitude. Today, all of those outmoded views have been integrated into traditional patriarchal relations. But it is important to note that the Islamic fundamentalists present their reactionary views as, quote, anti-imperialist struggle, or, quote, liberation from imperialism, using the fact that the West, which was the cradle of these anti-feudal developments, has become a destructive, plundering, and colonialist vampire. Yes, these fundamentalist forces use the fact of what imperialism is to portray their reactionary return to traditional views and oppressive theocratic social relations as, quote, emancipatory.
اما هرگز ذره ای از چارچوبه های اساسی وابستگی به سیستم سرمایه‌داری امپریالیستی جهانی گسست نکردند و آن را حفظ کردند و در این چارچوب قانون شریعت و به ویژه اخلاقیات ارتجایی در مورد زنان را رواج دادند. به این ترتیب در ایران زندانی کردن زن در لباس‌های گشاد و حجاب و قتل ناموسی قانونی شد. متأسفانه بسیاری از روشنفکران ناراضی از ستم امپریالیستی در فرموله کردن این جهانبینی و برنامه اجتماعی ارتجایی خدمت کردند. مثلا نگاه کنید به علی شریعتی در ایران که با الهام از امثال فانون در الجزایر، جولیوس در تانزانیا، جمو کنیاتا در کنیا، لئود پولسنگور در سنگال. بازگشت به خیش یعنی بازگشت به اسلام شیعه و اخلاقیات و فرهنگ ارتجایی آن را راه رهایی قلمداد کرد. این روشنفکران تاریکندیش در واقع اذهان را برای قدرتگیری رژیم آیت الله در ایران آماده کردند. یکی از شاگردان شریعتی زهرا رهنورد همسر میرحسین موسوی است که اکنون در حبس خانگی است. او حجاب را با ادبیات ضد استعماری برای رژیم آیت الله ها فرموله کرد.
While integrating themselves within the framework of dependence on the global imperialist capitalist system, these Islamic fundamentalists revived and promoted traditional oppressive social relations, especially the traditional relations related to the oppression of women. Therefore, in Iran, the imprisoning of women in loose clothes and hijab and honor killings have been legalized. Unfortunately, many intellectuals dissatisfied with imperialist oppression helped formulate this reactionary worldview and social program. Take, for example, Ali Shariati in Iran, who was inspired by the likes of Frantz Fanon in Algeria, Julius Nyerere in Tanzania, Jomo Kenyatta in Kenya, Leopold Senghor in Senegal. Shariati advocated, quote, returning to self, returning to Shiite Islam as the way to liberation. In this way, he prepared the theoretical basis for the Ayatollah's regime to rise to power in Iran. One of his students, Zahra Rahnavar, who was the wife of Mir Hossein Mousavi, integrated the hijab into an anti-colonial discourse and tool for the Ayatollah's regime to use.
Yeah. در نگاه رهنورد، بی حجاب شدن زنان تجاوز کلکتیو غرب امپریالیستی به مردم ایران بود. این نظریه خدمت بزرگی به منحرف کردن افکار از این واقعیت کرد که در عصر سرمایه‌داری امپریالیستی همه کشورها فارغ از اینکه چه نسخه حکومتی دارند در این سیستم جهانی ادغام شدند و عمدتاً طبق قوانین سرمایه جهانی عمل می‌کنند و شکل می‌گیرند. و طبقات استثمارگر سرمایه‌دار فارغ از اینکه چه ایدئولوژی خاصی دارند طبق قانون سرمایه‌داری و در خدمت به ملزومات استثمار و فوق استثمار برای سوداوری عمل می‌کنند. در ایران قوانین سرمایه‌داری زنان را به ورطه استثمار سرمایه‌داری می‌کشد و روبنای شریعت اسلامی تلاش می‌کند آنها را در زنجیرهای اسارت دینی نگه دارد. جالب است که معیار رهنورد در مورد زن کامل هر دوی اینا را در بر میگیرد. او میگوید زن کامل این است که هم در جامعه فعال باشد و هم دارای اصالت باشد. منظورش از فعال بودن این است که تحت دینامیک های سرمایه‌داری تبدیل به کارکنان سرمایه‌داری شود و منظورش از اصالت این است که به اسارت مرد پدرسالاری سنتی دینی تن دهد. و رعایت حجاب اسلامی توسط زنان علامت دادن به سیستم سرمایه‌داری دینمدار است که هم تن به استثمار سرمایه‌داری می‌دهد و هم به ستمگری سنتی از نوع دینی آن.
In the view of these theorists such as Shariati and Rahnavard, the unveiling of women was collective aggression of the imperialist West against the Iranian people. This theory did a great service in diverting attention away from the fact that in the age of capitalism imperialism, all countries, regardless of what version of government they have, are integrated into this world system and operate and function largely according to the laws of world capital. And the capitalist exploiting classes, regardless of their particular ideology, act in accordance with the laws of capitalism and in the service of the requirements of exploitation and super-exploitation for profit. In Iran, capitalist laws drag women into the abyss of capitalist exploitation. The Islamic Sharia superstructure tries to keep them in the chains of religious bondage. It is interesting that Rahnavard's criteria for the, quote, perfect woman includes both of these. She says that a perfect woman is one who is both active in society and has, quote, originality. By being, quote, active, she means becoming a capitalist employee under the dynamics of capitalism. And by, quote, authenticity, she means to submit to the bondage of the traditional religious patriarchy. And the observance of the Islamic hijab by women is a signal to the religious capitalist system that the acquiescences to both capitalist exploitation and traditional religious oppression.
Yeah. در هر حال توجه به این نکته مهم است، به ویژه آنکه اکنون بسیاری از روشنفکران میخواهند به مبارزه علیه امپریالیسم بپیوندند و به جای رویکرد علمی کمونیسم نوین به همین تئوری‌های منسوخ دست میاندازند. و حتما شما در کمپایی که برای دفاع از مردم فلسطین در دانشگاه‌ها برقرار شده با افکاری که تحت عنوان جنبش رهایی از امپریالیسم و ضد استعماری و غیره مواجه شده اید.
I'm giving this background because many intellectuals who want to join the struggle against imperialism resort to outmoded theories instead of a scientific approach, the new communism. You most likely have encountered these kinds of views in the college encampments that have been set up in many universities to defend the Palestinian people. They mainly look at the problem as colonialism rather than the whole capitalist imperialist system itself. Even though they call their movement the movement of liberation from imperialism or anti-colonialism, nevertheless, their understanding is not to end all outmoded systems of oppression and exploitation.
اما واقعیت این است که تناقضات زیادی در جهان وجود دارد و ویژگی‌های خاصی برای این تناقضات وجود دارد. سرکوب زنان و روابط مردسالاری در جهان و از جمله در ایران با افزایش وحشیگری تجدید می‌شود. مبارزه بین جمهوری‌خواهان فاشیست و دموکرات‌های نسل‌کشی نیز تجدید می‌شود. این دو منسوخ انتخاب‌هایی برای بشریت نیستند. سرکوب زنان، جنگ‌های امپریالیستی، نابودی محیط زیست و نسل‌کشی در غزه، اینها همه بخشی از عملکرد اساسی این سیستم هستند. ما چه باید بکنیم؟
There are many contradictions in the world, and there are certain particularities to these contradictions, including the oppression of women and patriarchal relations in the world. These contradictions are intensifying with increasing ferocity. The fight between the fascist Republicans and genocidal Democrats in America is intensifying as well. These two outmoded are not choices for humanity, with their oppression of women, imperialist wars, destruction of the environment, and the genocide in Gaza. These are all part of the basic functioning of this system. But what should we do? Or what is to be done?
Yeah. در عین اینکه علیه همه این جنایت‌ها باید جبهه‌های نبرد مشخص داشت، اما باید همه را به یک نبرد بزرگ برای انقلاب پیوند زد. جنگ بزرگ برای انقلاب نیازمند تئوری انقلابی است که باباکیان آن را در ادامه مارکس تکامل بیشتر داده است که نامش کمونیسم نوین است. همانطور که انقلابای سوسیالیستی قرن بیستم ابتدا در شوروی و سپس در چین بدون مارکسیسم که توسط مارکس بنیانگذاری شد و تکامل یافت و توسط لنین و ماو گسترش بیشتری پیدا کرد، امکان نداشت که تکامل بیشتری پیدا کند. امروز انقلابای سوسیالیستی بدون کمونیسم نوین که توسط باباکیان تکامل داده شده است ممکن نیست.
While we are engaging in many different battles against all these crimes against humanity, we revolutionaries are waging these battles with the aim and goal of a real revolution. The revolution we need requires revolutionary theory, which has been further developed by Babavakian. This is the new communism. It is a continuation of, but also represents a qualitative leap beyond, and in some important ways a break with, communist theory as it had been previously developed. Just as the socialist revolutions of the 20th century, first in the Soviet Union and then in China, would not have been possible without Marxism, which was founded and developed by Marx and further developed by Lenin and Mao, socialist revolutions in our time are not possible without the new communism developed by Babavakian.
پیوند زدن نبردهای امروز به انقلاب با به کار بستن کمونیسم نوین ممکن است. یعنی سیاستهای دخالتگری در هر مبارزه ای از آزادی زندانیان سیاسی تا متوقف کردن نسل کشی در غزه با الزامات آماده شدن برای نبرد بزرگ انقلاب، یعنی نیروهایی را که در هر نبرد فوری به میدان می آوریم برای نبرد بزرگ انقلاب سازماندهی کنیم. بنابراین باید با نظریه‌های غلط و شیوه‌های تفکر غلط که در رایج هستند و مردم رو در سیستم محبوس نگه می‌دارد مقابله کنیم. تعداد زیادی از مردم ضرورت تغییر رادیکال را به شدت احساس می‌کنند. برای اینکه ببینند راه واقعی برای چنین تغییری هست، باید با جهان‌بینی‌های غلط سیاسی که در میانشان رواج دارد بجنگیم. آنان باید به طور علمی درک کنند که هیچ چیز مثبتی از سمتگیری با جمهوری اسلامی یا با امپریالیسم آمریکا حاصل نخواهد شد. هر کس از امپریالیسم آمریکا متنفر است، باید از جمهوری اسلامی هم متنفر باشد، و هر کس از جمهوری اسلامی متنفر است، باید از امپریالیسم آمریکا هم متنفر باشد.
It is possible to link today's battles to the revolution we need by applying the new communism. In other words, in waging major struggles of today, like the struggle to free political prisoners or stopping the genocide in Gaza, even though the immediate goals of these particular struggles are not necessarily the same as fighting for communism, in entering these struggles, we revolutionaries engage them through a scientific lens. These immediate battles are part of preparing the ground for revolution. Many of the forces for the future revolution will come from today's struggles. Therefore, we must take on the erroneous theories and wrong ways of thinking that keep people locked into the system and struggle to break people from these prevailing ideas. Great numbers of people feel the necessity for radical change. In order for people to see that there is a real way for such a change, we need to challenge people's thinking, bring a scientific understanding to them. People must scientifically come to understand why nothing positive will come out of siding with the Islamic Republic of Iran or with U.S. imperialism. Anyone who hates and opposes American imperialism can come to understand why they should also hate and oppose the Islamic Republic. And anyone who hates and opposes the Islamic Republic should also come to understand why they should also hate and oppose American imperialism.
Yeah. به طور مشخص‌تر باید گفت هر کس به طور جدی خواهان توقف نسل‌کشی آمریکا و اسرائیل در غزه است، باید به طور جدی خواهان آزادی فوری زندانیان سیاسی، توقف فوری اعدام‌ها، توقف فوری سرکوب زنان به خاطر حجاب اسلامی در ایران باشد، و هر کس به طور جدی از خیزش جینا و خواسته‌هایش، از توماج صالحی و صدایش، از آزادی فوری زندانیان سیاسی در ایران و توقف اعدام‌ها حمایت می‌کند، باید به جنبش توقف نسل‌کشی در غزه توسط آمریکا و اسرائیل بپیوندد.
More specifically, anyone who seriously wants to stop the US and Israeli genocide in Gaza could come to understand that they also need to join into fight to demand the immediate release of Iran's political prisoners. To put an immediate halt to executions in Iran and an immediate end to the repression of women by the Islamic regime and their draconian hijab law in Iran. And on the other hand, anyone who seriously supports Jina's uprising and its demands, anyone who fights to free Toomaj Salehi and his voice, anyone who fights for the immediate release of political prisoners in Iran and the halt to executions could through struggle come to understand and join the movement to stop the genocide in Gaza by the United States and Israel as well.
ما در یک سیستم زندگی می‌کنیم که به شکل‌های مختلف بشریت را تحت آزار و ستم قرار می‌دهد و کره زمین را دارد نابود می‌کند. الان موقعی است که پیام انقلاب را به مردم برسونیم و با قدرت بجنگیم و مردم را آماده بکنیم با تغییر افکار مردم را آماده بکنیم برای انقلاب و ساختن جامعه بنیادن متفاوت، جامعه سوسیالیستی و رسیدن به رهایی کل بشریت. Thank you.
We are all facing the same system that is an existential threat for the future of humanity, that is also destroying the planet. This is a time to spread the message of real revolution, to be fighting the crimes of the system and transforming people's thinking for revolution, and to be rapidly building up the forces for and getting into position to make the revolution, to put an end to this system and to emancipate humanity. Thank you.
Thank you so much, everybody.
And thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Two things should go without saying. After, number one, you're not going to hear that anywhere else or from anyone else other than the revolutionaries who are bringing forward and fighting to bring forward followers and a new generation of revolutionaries around the new communism. In this country, in Iran, in Colombia, in Mexico, and everywhere else in the world, it's needed. Thank you, Mona, for coming and joining us today. Are we still good with the stream and everything good? Great. Everybody all right?
Yeah.
At the end, we're going to have a little bit of Q&A and discussion that we can also do. So, right?
Yeah,
so we can follow up if people want to actually engage and ask and dig into some of that. It was pretty... This is battlefield, right? Medua Jung means battlefield, right? Yeah. Okay, we have one more talk from Raymond Lada and then a few messages of support, but I wanted to show one more video from Toomaj. Is that okay?
Yeah.
On the live stream, you all right? Can't hear you.
که وقت ساختن تو دل دشمن بدون ترسه میدون جنگه دارا و ندار اثر قوم و تبار مثل فشنگ قطار میدون جنگ تیغه شمشیر عشق شهامت و زین کن و جنس سفر وفا فصل اتحاده من که اختلاف افتخاره تکه کنم به هم وطن به شب تکه گاهش شروع خروش و تقیان مردمه چشم ساره فصل سمزداییه وسط باز و حزب باده هر تفکری که داری با هر دین و آین کنارمون بیست سالها کنار تیستادیم ما نره خشمه هزار بی صداییم شورشی کمریشه ی انقلابی داریم عرب و آشوری ارمنی ترکمن مازنی سیستانی و بلوچ و تالش و تاتو آذری کرد و گیلک لور فارسی قشقایی ما اتحاد رودهاییم دریاییم ورزشکار و هنرمند دست فروش تا کاسب از محصل و معلم مهندس تا کارگر میکنیم کرکوش دیکتاتور و با ساز حق زن زندگی آزادی میجنگیم تا پای مرگ شونه به شونه پا به پا دیوار دفاعی باورم به هم بستگی مثل ایمان الهی مثل مسخ دین مثل مجنون بی باکس سینه چاکی میران تومه مطیع این بیگانه ها نیست میدون جنگه اثر رنگی هستی بیا که بدون تو یه خونه لنگه میدون جنگه بیا که وقت تاختن تو دل دشمن بدون ترسه میدون جنگه دارا و ندار اثر قوم و تبار مثل فشنگ قطار میدون جنگه تیغه شمشیر عشق شهامت و زین کن و جنس سفر وفا دستای گره تو دست هم جهان تو دست ما دانشجوی قهرمان تا خیابون و رفت فارس ایران و فروختم رفیق رفت خونت به باد وقت تصفیه میذاریم جلوشون صورت حساب میدون جنگه خورشید و گرفتن خواب خوش به شب نذاریم براشون نه تلاطمم موج دارم پشتبانم به ایرانه به میلیونه بده کاریم به این خونه آزادی رو آبادی رو بده کاریم و شادی رو واسه دیکتاتور و شغالاش و حامیاش بند و گرفتاری رو میدون جنگه جان ازم پا پس نکش با جنم با هم تهش رو میبینیم چون فتح میکنیم میبینید که جنگی شدیم چه نسلی تولید کردید که ریز و درشش هم زدتن بی باکه تشه یه جور آزادی از زندگی سیرابه شکوه ما اتحاد آیندتون سیاهه شبه میشیم تو شب کابوس میشیم براتون در پس این دوزخ فانوس دیدیم در آن سو دار جلو دارم نیست نه سرکوب و نه قانون نره میکشم و میام که جوی پر هیاهو میدون جنگه اثر رنگی هستی بیا که بدون تو یه خونه لنگه میدون جنگه بیا که وقت تاختن تو دل دشمن بدون ترسه میدون جنگه دارا و ندار اثر قوم و تبار مثل فشنگ قطار میدون جنگه تیغه شمشیر عشق شهامت و زین کن و جنس سپر وفا
it's okay, you can't see me with the light. We're going to show one more video. We're going to just show 2 or 3 minutes of this video before we continue. Everyone stick with it. We have a very important presentation from Raymond Lada and a few more statements of solidarity and support. We're going to start watching this video. As I've said it 3 times already, but you could spend, as I have, many, many nights digging through and watching Toomaj's music videos, his interviews, and his statements. I want to just say that, you know, there's many artists and many poets and intellectuals and revolutionaries, people who've been forced to leave Iran. And one of the things that I recently learned, having been a fan of and knowing Toomaj, and we were actually trying to do some music with him a few years ago, Toomaj chose to stay in Iran, and he chose to not flee, and he chose, I don't want to say flee, he chose to stay in Iran and make these songs and inspire and instigate the overthrow of the Islamic Republic, as you can see through his songs. He was, the video that we watched at the beginning talked about how he had been in prison 1 or 2 times before. Toomaj got released in, again, and you know, as you know, Mona, who spoke, who was a political prisoner, he's one of thousands of political prisoners. But Toomaj is very well known and has many fans, many followers, including many young people. But I just want, you know, when he was in prison last year, and I have some friends, Persian artists, people were saying, oh, he's given up. Toomaj has given up. In other words, when he was in prison, the regime tortured him as they torture people. And one of the things that they try to do for while they torture people is get them to confess their crimes against God. That's his crime, by the way. When Toomaj was released on a technicality, the Supreme Court overturned his sentence last October. He had been in prison for a year. People had said, you know, they were spreading rumors that he had said sorry for all his music and all of this stuff. And he came out and he gave this message. And we're not going to watch the whole thing. You can watch the rest of it at home. But I thought it would be helpful to, or interesting. This is in October, before he was in, and he was imprisoned. He was released after 1 year. Made this statement, and a week after making this statement, he was imprisoned again and has since gotten the death penalty.
Miles?
Yes?
Could we take down the podium, please?
Yes.
Okay. Thank
you. Yes. Thank you. I got it. You guys see all right on the live stream? Mm-hmm. We're about here. Everybody's okay?
Yeah.
A little bit more than that.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to watch this video of Toomaj right now. This is when he was released last year. Just watch the first few minutes of it.
دوستان سلام، ارادت، امیدوارم حالتون خوب باشه. امروز 5/9/402 اولین ویدیویی که من از خودم منتشر میکنم. ویدیوی دیگه‌ای که از من داره پخش میشه توی فضای مجازی مال ویدئوی بعد از آزادی سال 1400 که برای آهنگ سوراخ میش منو گرفته بودم. ببخشید که این مقدار دیر اومدم عرض ادب بکنم، به خاطر اینکه یه کوچولو فشار روانی روم بود و داشتم در واقع باهاش یه جوری کلنجا میرفتم تا به اون حالت نورمال برسم. آدم حالا عکس رو میتونه خودش رو خوب نشون بده، یک ثانیه است یه لبخند میزنی عکس میگیری، ولی ویدیو خب خیلی مشخصه حالت چطوره و میخواستم حالا خوب باشه، خیلی خوب باشه وقتی که میام، که هست الان. اول از همه، مهمتر از همه، میخواستم تشکر کنم از همه تون به خاطر رویه حامی بودنتون، نه فقط به خاطر اینکه از من حمایت کردیم، به خاطر اینکه از هر کسی که بهتون نیاز داره حمایت کردیم توی این مدت و همبستگی رو نشون دادید که من به شخصه ندیده بودم هیچ وقت، به خاطر اینکه خسته نشدیم، به خاطر اینکه ما فراموش نکردیم، به خاطر اینکه بچه های اکباتان رو هنوز فراموش نکردیم، بچه هایی که هنوز توی حسر هستن رو فراموش نکردید. دمتون گرم. یه چیز خارق‌العاده‌ای بوده، حداقل برای من خیلی چیز بزرگی بوده. هر بار که به نحوی، حتی وقتی توی بازداشتگاه اطلاعات بودم، خب اونجا حتی صحبت کردنم یه جورای نشدنیه با خانواده، به خاطر اینکه ملاقات ها خیلی کوتاهن و مأمور کنارتون هست و اجازه نمیده صحبت کنید در مورد هر چیزی. ولی اونجا هم گاهی یه چیز کوچیکی، یه خبر کوچیکی از اینکه از من یا از دیگران دارید حمایت میکنید به من میرسید و این خیلی 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 زیاد دلگرم کننده بود، یه انرژی دوباره بود. اگه این چیزا نبود که خب قطعا ما هم مثل بقیه کسایی که اونجا میومدن و آسیب میدیدن، آسیب روانی میدیدن، نمیتونستیم تحمل کنیم. خودم رو عزم میکنم و بقیه بچه های سیاسی که اومدن و رفتن. من راستش اولین ویدیوی دارم میگیرم، نمیدونم، بعد یکم سختم راستش و یه سری نکته هست که بعد از تشکر میخواستم بگم. یکی این که خیلی 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 قوی دارن حمله میکنن به من، حالا که نتونستن نگه هم دارن توی زندان و به خاطر شماست که من نجات دادین از اونجا و البته قبلش جونم رو نجات دادین و یک بار هم سال 400 باز من رو نجات دادین، سه بار شما من رو نجات دادین. حالا خیلی جاها به من میگن قهرمان، در صورتی که من یه آدم خیلی معمولی هستم و قهرمان شماید که من رو نجات دادین. من که کسی رو نتونستم نجات دادم جایی، هرگز. بله، حالا که نتونستم من نگه دارن مثل دفعات قبل سعی میکنن تخریب کنن به چیه من رو، حالا مثلا با یه سری تهمت های البته همراه با لومپنیز که میگن اعتراف کرده کیا رو لو داده. آخه من کیو داشتم که لو بدم؟ اولا اعتراف بکنم چی رو اعتراف بکنم؟ من که همه چیزم توی همین گوشی ها بوده دیگه، چیزی که پنهان نداشتم که بخوام اعترافش بکنم. دو، براشون رپ که نخوندم، که کاری که میتونستم بکنم فقط همینی که براشون رپ بخونم دیگه، که اون کارم که مشخصا نکردم و عوامل تهیه موسیقی هم هیچ کدوم دستگیر نشدن بعد از من، حالا یا قبل از من البته، نه کارگردان، نه آهنگساز، نه کسی دیگه، نه بچه هایی که کاور کار میکردن، نه هیچ کسی دیگه. و من خیلی شکنجه شدم اون موقع بازداشت، دست و پای من رو شکوندن، یعنی تو صورتم و سرم خیلی ضربه میزدن، سعی میکردم اول با دستام جلوی ضربات رو بگیرم که انگشتام میشکستن و بعد دیگه خیلی چیز حالا تعریف کردنی نیست، جالب نیست، ولی خیلی تایمش هم خیلی طولانی بود. یکی از بچه های سیاسی به من گفت که احتمالاً اون چیزی که توی گردن زدن آدرنالین بوده برای اینکه بیهوش نشی و اون تایم شکنجه رو، اون زمانی که شکنجت میکنن، همش به هوش باشی و درد رو تا اوجش تحمل کنی. و این در مورد اعتراف که من پیجم هم ندادم دیگه، همین روز آخر هم ساعت خانواده من ساعت 9 و 10 صبح منتظر آزادی من بودن. اول اینکه از پنج شنبه آزادم نکردن تا شنبه، این طبق قانون خود جمهوری اسلامیه که بیشتر از یک سال نمیتونستم من بازداشت موقت نگه دارم و همون 6 سالی هم که من دادم باز طبق قانون جمهوری اسلامی نیست، غیر قانونیه. و البته وقتی ما در مورد قانون خودشون باهاشون صحبت میکردیم میخندیدن که چی میگی و قانون چی میگی و ما میتونیم فلان کار میکنیم. به هر صورت آره، و اون روز آخرم که روز شنبه که من آزاد شدم، از صبح تا فکر کنم 4-5 ساعت فکر میکنم برده بودم پیش آقای براتی، اومده بود قاضی پروندم و اون آقای این اطلاعاتی که فکر کنم نمیدونم حالش کار است، ولی خب کارشناس پرونده من، یعنی بالاترین فکر کنم باشه توی پرونده من، در واقع همونی که دستور شکنجه من رو داده بود، اومده بودن و صحبت میکردیم که پیج تو بمون بده. و حالا من نمیخوام یه حالتی باشه که داستان تعریف کنم، ولی خب یه چند ساعتی اونجا صحبت داشتیم که من میگفتم همینجا میمونم توی زندان، ولی پیجم رو به شما.
I'm sorry to cut Toomaj off there. I wanted to, we weren't going to show this video, but I wanted to show it to give you guys a sense of, first of all, you get a sense of who he is, right?
Yeah.
Just, this is a guy, this is a boxer. He's a boxer.
Sky will knock you out. This is a, no, I'm serious, and you can see how skinny he is here. They've tortured him for a year. And he's sitting there, and you can even see how he's nervous with his fingers. Because he knows that if he says one thing, he could say, he's talking to his fans. This is right. If he says one thing, he could probably save his ass. What I did was really wrong. What I did was really bad. Wasn't, you know. And he goes on in this. You can watch all the videos we've watched today on YouTube. I encourage everyone to watch them. You can watch the rest of this. He goes into detail. some of it's actually funny how he was telling the interrogation officer he's going to take him to court. But he makes it very clear here, as he said, kind of funny, what do I have to confess? My music, my art, everything is in public. But I just thought it would be nice to share this. You also, besides just his music video, I mean, this is a beautiful person. Everyone who's been, you know, and I just wanted to add one thing. Raymond Lada, please get ready. You're coming up. But I just wanted to say something. In Mona's presentation was so deep. Including just the hypocrisy and bankruptcy of bringing out this Dark Ages Islamic fundamentalism as if it's somehow liberating or anti-colonial. I just have to say that if we are to become successful in this country or in another country and are able to institute actual revolutionary societies, for example, new socialist republics, you'd be damn sure we're not going to be executing people who disagree with us.
Right.
And that will be enshrined in law, and you can read that in the Constitution for the new socialist republic in North America. And for the million and one crimes of the Islamic Republic, I have to say to what you described happened to you and so many others, being pregnant as a youngster, in your 20s, in a revolutionary, and be given birth in prison, when someone like this, whose music, 10, 15, 20 songs of which are obviously created with tremendous, not only brilliance, talent, and skill, but tremendous selflessness, you execute people like that. You're irrelevant in the conversation around what's a forward step for ending oppression. And I just want to say that. All right, we're going to move along right now. We're going to hear from two more things before this program ends. Number one, Raymond Lada. Please come up, Raymond. We're going to get the podium. Excellent. I'm going to introduce Raymond in a second. And then after Raymond, we're going to hear a few more statements of solidarity and poetry that have been sent in. I'll help you in a second. A few more statements of solidarity with Toomaj and the struggle against the persecution and execution of political prisoners. Great, thank you. Here. Everybody good?
Yeah.
All right, next up, we're going to introduce Raymond Lada, who's a spokesperson for Revolution Books, an author and writer, longtime revolutionary communist theoretician, and writer whose work you can read printed here and also on the website revcom.us. Raymond.
All right. Stop the execution of Toomaj.
Yeah. Right.
We stand with those risking all for a whole new world. The battle to stop the execution of Toomaj and to free Iran's political prisoners, this is our battle. That's the title of this talk. And I speak to you as an advocate for the new communism developed by Bob Avakian and as a spokesperson for Revolution Books. The new communism teaches that the whole world comes first, that the revolution we are about is a revolution to emancipate all of humanity. At this bookstore, And what you see on the shelves in the discussions and debates that take place here, in what we raise people's sights to, the whole world comes first. Which is to say, Toomaj and the other Iranian political prisoners, they are our brothers and sisters. The system we live under is a global system of exploitation and oppression, with its supply chains of misery stretching from the children mining the coltan that powers your cell phones to the women stitching together your clothing, earning $4 a day in the hellhole sweatshops of Bangladesh, to the millions of migrant refugees in the world seeking to cross the southern border of the US, the Mediterranean borders of Europe, and other borders across the world, fleeing poverty, conflict, and environmental catastrophe caused by the agricultural plunder and wars of imperialism, and by the profit-based oil and natural gas foundation of the world imperialist economy. Drowning, dying of heat, rounded up, and demonized for risking their lives to survive and live as human beings. And America is the greatest exploiter and oppressor in this world system. And America is the greatest beneficiary of the horrors of this system. It is US imperialism that is arming, bankrolling, and giving diplomatic cover to Israel's genocide in Gaza. All of which leads me to this powerful statement from Bob Avakian. If you can conceive of a world without America, without everything America stands for and does in the world, then you've already taken great strides and begun to get a glimpse of a whole new world. If you can envision a world without any imperialism, exploitation, and oppression, and the whole philosophy that rationalizes it, a world without division into classes or even different nations, and all the narrow-minded, selfish, outmoded ideas that uphold this, if you can envision this, then you have the basis for proletarian internationalism. And once you have raised your sights to all this, how could you not feel compelled to take an active part in the world historic struggle to realize it? Why would you want to lower your sights to anything else? What does this have to do with building support for Toomaj, Salehi, and the other Iranian political prisoners? Everything. We have an internationalist responsibility to our brothers and sisters in the prisons of Iran. Everyone who cares for justice must understand how much the people of Iran have suffered at the hands of US imperialism. In 1953, the US CIA engineered a coup against the progressive regime of Mohammad Mossadegh and installed one of the most brutal rulers in modern history, the Shah of Iran, leading to 25 years of misery, repression, and torture, serving US dominance in the Persian Gulf and Middle East. The Shah's secret police were trained by the CIA and its offspring in Israel. In 1979, as a revolution to oust the Shah was gaining hurricane force, with secular leftists, revolutionaries, and revolutionary communists playing a critical role, the US saw in the political Islam of the Ayatollah Khomeini and his networks a force that could hijack this struggle, turn it away from revolutionary transformation, and help the US in the Middle East, especially against its then global imperialist rival, the Soviet Union. And an awful reign of terror followed and continues to this day. The Woman Life Freedom Uprising was a cry of half of humanity for all of humanity. It shook the rule of the Islamic Republic like no other upsurge since the 1980s. Now, it is a fact that the rulers of Iran have come into conflict with U.S. imperialism over the last two decades. And as Mona pointed out, they draped themselves in the mantle of anti-imperialism for their own ideological, political purposes at home and in the region. But this regime, as Mona also pointed out, is completely entwined with the world imperialist system. It worked with the Bush administration in the early phases of the so-called War on Terror. This is a woman-hating theocracy that exploits and oppresses in a capitalist imperialist world framework that impoverishes and punishes its population of 80 million people in a capitalist imperialist world framework. This regime does not stand for an end to imperialism and oppression. It allies, when convenient, with imperialist powers today, with Russian and Chinese imperialism. This regime does not stand for liberation. It denies basic rights and freedom of expression. Yet, there are so-called leftists and others who argue that to criticize Iran is to play into the hands of U.S. imperialism. And even more obscenely, that to raise the rallying cry to free Iranian political prisoners is to become a tool of Western meddling and interference. This is worse than nonsense. It is a betrayal of our brothers and sisters who are courageously fighting repression and against a draconian regime. And this contributes to the phony veneer of this regime as some keystone of a supposed axis of resistance. That's the term that the Iranian regime and its followers, its lackeys and acolytes use. Axis of resistance. Resistance to what? This is not resistance to poverty, oppression, and systems of exploitation. Nor is it resistance to enslaving ideas, culture and customs. This is a regime that rules through branding irons, bayonets, imprisonment, torture, and thought control. Here's a fact for those proponents of axis of resistance. Iran has the second highest number of women writers in prison of any country in the world. Fuck this axis of resistance. The International Emergency Campaign to Free Political Prisoners, and this program today is in solidarity, and is an expression, and is contributing to the work of this International Emergency Campaign. Well, this campaign to free Iran's political prisoners makes it very clear, and the point has been made strongly in this program, and it can't be made frequently enough. We oppose this horrific regime, the Islamic Republic of Iran, and at the same time, we stand against any and all attempts by U.S. imperialism, whatever the pretext, to subvert Iran, to attack Iran, to strangle Iran with sanctions that prevent Iran from getting essential goods. And that has led to thousands of unnecessary deaths. So here we are. World humanity faces a particular situation today that Mona also touched on. It is what Bob Avakian has called the clash of the two outmoded, the historically outmoded strata among colonized and oppressed humanity up against historically outmoded ruling strata of this highly globalized imperialist system. Both of these outmoded feed on, supplement, and reinforce each other politically and ideologically. The Western imperialists carry out their military interventions. Yes, they're inventing new military means of destroying the planet. Carry out their military interventions, their war crimes, and economic plunder. And the Islamic fundamentalists gain some legitimacy. The Islamic fundamentalists resort to their medieval practices, to sexual, ethnic, and political persecution, to acts of terrorism, and the Western imperialism gain face as avatars of enlightenment and tolerance. And we must be clear that it is the outmoded ruling strata, as Bob Avakian emphasizes, the outmoded ruling strata of imperialism who has done the greater damage and poses the greater threat to humanity. There must be another way. Well, there is another way. It is a revolution guided by the new communism to finally put an end to all exploitation and oppression. And it is a crucial and inspiring fact that in Iran there is a force, the Communist Party of Iran, Marxist-Leninist, Maoist, that is taking up and applying the new communism under extremely difficult and repressive conditions. Look, just handing out flyers in the streets can get you a long prison sentence in Iran. This party was joining with and bringing the message of all-the-way revolution to the upsurge against the forced hijab and the brutal subjugation of women. It is extremely precious that such a revolutionary vanguard exists in Iran and in the world. It is organizing for the revolution, making its contribution to the worldwide revolution guided by the new communism, in which, and listen to me closely, in which the struggle for the complete emancipation of women, as Bob Avakian has put it, is not only a crucial component propelling and driving forward the struggle to overthrow the rule of capitalism imperialism. This struggle for the complete emancipation of women is also a driving force within the new socialist society to continue with that struggle as a key aspect to achieve a communist world without exploitation and oppression. So yes, where I started, the whole world comes first. The battle to stop the execution of Toomaj and to free Iran's political prisoners is one that advances the cause of emancipating all of humanity. We may not have met those prisoners, but they are our sisters and brothers. In taking the stand that we are today in this room, and for those of you watching, wherever you are, in communicating our message to those in the dungeons of the Islamic Republic who are refusing to bow down, carrying out hunger strikes, issuing messages of solidarity to the Palestinian people, in taking this stand and acting, we draw closer, we cross boundaries, we learn from their heroism, and it is especially important in this belly of the beast of U.S. imperialism that we awaken people to this internationalist cause and to our internationalist responsibility. And we are carrying out this campaign, this battle, to stop the execution of Toomaj and to free all Iran's political prisoners, not just at any time, but in this rare time in the U.S. when revolution is more possible. The rulers, the war criminal Democrats and the fascist Republicans are at each other's throats. They haven't been this divided since the run-up to the Civil War. And this infighting may be coming to a boiling point, likely coming to a boiling point around the time of the November elections. And you know what? When the slave masters fight each other, that creates more space and a historic opening for the slaves and all who yearn for a better world to rise up. And we can see how quickly people change. A new generation of student rebels has taken the stage in U.S. society through the struggle to stop the genocide in Gaza. And you can learn more about all this and the strategy for revolution by digging deeply into the messages at Bob Avakian Official. So what are our next steps? To step up the battle to prevent the execution of Toomaj and to free Iran's political prisoners? Well, we have to continue to sign and spread the statement for Toomaj. We have to get Toomaj's songs played on the radio and at pro-Palestinian encampments. We need to make individual and group videos of solidarity to be sent on to the international emergency campaign. And mark June 20th on your calendar, because here in New York, there will be protests and manifestations as part of an international day of support of political prisoners in Iran. Brothers and sisters, let our voices be heard as one. Thank you.
This is a poem that was sent from Rafael Jesus Gonzalez, the first poet laureate of Berkeley, California. And I'm told that Rafael is watching on the live stream. So this is a poem that he sent called The Hair of Women for Gina Massa Amini. The hair of women, tightly curled as fine merino wool, or loosely like the vine's tendril, or wavy like ripples in a pond, or straight as a horse's mane, must not be seen in public, say the men who rule, because they say that it incites men's lust according to their idea of God, toxic, patriarchal. But oppression breeds rebellion, and your heart burst with need of freedom to let the sun warm your hair, let loose for the wind to comb it, the moon caress it. For this simple act you were taken, imprisoned, beaten, and you died. But your death was a spark that set aflame the tinder of women's curtailed lives, and they took to the streets worldwide. Stand, sisters, for the woman, life, freedom. And we, your brothers, stand with you, because no one is free unless women are. Mary Lou Greenberg is going to share some more statements and words with us. Thank you, Mary Lou.
Thank you. The first statement I have is from Gayatri Spivak. University Professor of English and Comparative Literature at Columbia University. I have worked with Iranian women for many years. I am with you shoulder to shoulder, raising my voice against the execution of Toomaj Salehi. Not only because he has spoken and sung against injustice, taking risks for the rights of humanity, but also because we must not kill. Long live Toomaj Salehi, long live life over death. Let us shout out for peace. The next statement is from Merle Hoffman, who is the founder and president of Choices Women's Medical Center in New York City, and a writer. She is a co-founder of Rise Up for Abortion Rights that was formed to stop the Supreme Court from making abortion illegal in the US. She is unable to be with us today, but sent the following message to this gathering. And this is from Merle. The three words, woman, life, freedom, have been the North Stars of my life and work. I was very moved reading about Toomaj and wrote this for him. For Toomaj Salehi, because you resisted, because you stood up, because you understand that woman, life, freedom means that you and the people refuse to be ruled by killers, because you do not live in the caves of fear and trembling, because seeing the truth is the first step of courage, because you took the second step and sung it to the world, because of Masha, because her crime was dancing with her hair in the wind. We will make each other strong, bold, and powerful, and our voices raised in protest and struggle will be the wind that will blow freedom to the people. All right. And the third statement that I'm happy to read is a special message to today's program from PEN America, which defends the right of expression of artists and writers. We are grateful to Revolution Books for raising attention to rapper Toomaj Salehi's outrageous death sentence. His case constitutes an egregious attack on human rights and free expression. We condemn this abhorrent act of the Revolutionary Court and demand the immediate release of Salehi, who has suffered constant persecution at the hands of the Iranian authorities over the past several years, particularly since his detention in the fall of 2022 during the Woman Life Freedom protests, when he was subjected to torture in custody. Artists like Salehi, who use their music and creativity to express dissent against draconian and unjust measures by authoritarian regimes, must be safeguarded from such deliberate violence in recognition of the universal and fundamental right to free expression and artistic freedom. We stand in solidarity with Salehi and other prisoners of conscience who remain detained and persecuted for championing artistic freedom and human rights. Thank you.
All right, thanks for everyone coming here today for this program. I hope you were inspired and provoked to join this movement, to help instigate a movement right now to stop the execution of Toomaj, free Toomaj, demand the freedom of all political prisoners in Iran, and as was so powerfully and with tremendous substance and revolutionary science by Mona and by Raymond as well, start to get an understanding that this is not just oh, well, here's another horrible thing happening in the world, but that this is a key thing. Freedom for a brother like this and the thousands of other political prisoners. And I took to heart what you said, Mona, as well, particularly that the revolutionaries of the future, well, the future that needs to happen right now, are going to hopefully come out of these struggles. But we're going to be come from fighting against these struggles right now. Are you guys passing me stuff? You got a message for me? Those listening on the live stream and those here today, I want to once again encourage people to, well, hopefully you were provoked by both of those presentations to dig deeper and get involved in the movement for an actual revolution. A lot of works, very deep and profound works, were referenced by the revolutionary leader, Bob Avakian. I also want to encourage people to be part of the fundraising drive to save this bookstore, Revolution Books. We're in a fund drive right now. You can find out more if you're here in the store at the back. You can talk to someone from the store or you can go on the website. And I don't know your name, but I'm told that someone from Amnesty International is here and would like to make a few remarks. So please come on up.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, everyone. My name's Deirdre Stieglitz. I'm on the board of directors of Amnesty International USA. I'm an activist, human rights activist for over 35 years. And I didn't come with the expectation that I was going to say anything, but I'm here because I, in solidarity with Toomaj and all of the other Iranian prisoners of conscience and all the human rights prisoners of conscience around the world, I care deeply about these causes, and Amnesty International is working hard to garner support to get Toomaj freed. I'd like to just read the messaging that's coming out to activists in Amnesty at the moment. Just some of it's a little redundant from what you have, but like I said, I didn't prepare a statement, so. We're all still in shock about the news that Toomaj Salehi, a popular Iranian rap musician and hip-hop artist, has been sentenced to death solely for his peaceful artistic expression in support of the protests that broke out in Iran in the fall of 2022, and for his criticism of the Iranian authorities, human rights violations. Amnesty International has been actively advocating for Toomaj since his first arrest. Toomaj was arrested in October 2022 and subjected to brutal torture, which led to several broken bones and damage to his eyes. He was convicted of corruption on earth and was originally sentenced to more than 6 years in prison and a ban on his artistic activities. But then a death sentence was handed down in April 2024. We are urging people to take action on our AIUSA website. There is a petition. We're getting it out globally. Amnesty International has over 7 million supporters worldwide. So adding your name to that petition would be really helpful as well. And there's an urgent action that's been released, which is like a letter writing action. You can fax, email, write an old-fashioned letter. But it's wording around what happened. And I just want to say Amnesty International's research, our reputation is very solid in that we do not give false information. These things really happened to Toomaj, and we're very concerned for his life at this point. So please take action. Thank you.
June 20th,
Thursday,
is an international day to build support for political prisoners in Iran, and we want to everyone to get involved in that. It's great that there's people here today. It's great that there's people on the live stream. But the 20th, you can get involved at the International Campaign to Free Political Prisoners in Iran's website. You can get involved with us here. It's really important. I'm so glad that you came from Amnesty International. There have been different efforts from different human rights groups. the fact of the matter is not enough is happening, though. And so we really need to turn this out and, you know, standing up. This is a lot bigger than Toomaj, but I want everyone also to know that standing up for Toomaj is standing up for the values that he represents. This is a statement from Geraldine Brooks, who reported from Iran on numerous occasions from the late 80s through the 1990s.
Won the Pulitzer Prize for fiction.
And won the Pulitzer... Just got to put that in the bio. And won the Pulitzer Prize for fiction. Toomaj is an example of the greatness of Iranian artists who, at immense sacrifice to themselves, have stayed in their homeland to fight for the heart and soul of their culture. The theological despots who rule so cruelly are just a thin crust atop a roiling population, a population that treasures its culture, at once ancient and vibrant. I stand with Toomaj and with the brave Iranian people who risk so much for the life of freedom they so richly deserve. Thank you for that, because we didn't get that second part, which was good. That was all these messages that were read here were sent for today's program. We're done. I want to really thank everyone for coming here today. For those who haven't been the whole time, or even for those who have been, I mean, I've not a day has gone by in the last 2 or 3 months where I wasn't up watching Toomaj's videos. And I hope it, you know, the point of this program is to build a movement to stop his execution as an important part of actually freeing political prisoners in Iran and making the revolution that humanity so urgently needs in that country, in this country, and all over the world. And I want to say, as an artist, got the peanut gallery over here, I swear it's... you know, this is the music and example and writing of Toomaj Salehi is something that I hope everyone here, and especially if we can reach other young people and other artists, well, obviously inspiring, but I hope it challenges you. Mm-hmm. First of all, the brother is a deep poet. Writes with tremendous imagery, and he has, you know, been tireless in inspiring and not being afraid to challenge and criticize people who, not just the mullahs and the theocracy, but those who find their way, their niche, to go along with things that should not be gone along with. And I've just been really inspired, and I want to give a shout out to Toomaj. I want to give a shout out to his best friend Afrasiab, who, as I said earlier, he's in the song Survivor, Basmandi. I think my accent's not so great.
Want to move on this. If people in this room want to make a solidarity message with Toomaj and a call to free all of Iran's political prisoners, we have wonderful technology at our disposal. So we're here. We have a lot of energy. We have a lot of new understanding and conviction and commitment. So speak from your heart. Deborah, I think, can video, or do it on a cell phone, and let's make the most of who's here and what we're feeling. So people can issue video statements or audio statements, 30 seconds, 1 minute, but let's do that, because this is all part of building up the momentum for what we have to be doing. And again, let's look towards June 20th as a day when we can bring a lot of this energy together and tell the world and let those prisoners in Iran know that we stand with them.